Dear heart, do you belong to me? Or do I belong to you? Just look at all the trouble you drag me into. I've heard it said to follow your heart, but I'm starting to wonder if it's gone too far.
Good morning, Pastor Larry here. It's Thursday, June the 18th, and so we're in Proverbs chapter 18 today. And there's a verse that just really stuck out to me right away this morning, and it was the second verse of chapter 18. The Bible says, "A fool hath no delight in understanding, but that his heart may discover itself." And you know, there's a phrase that sounds really good and has been used for years, and people still use it every day, and it makes people feel good when you say it. And it's this saying, just follow your heart. Just follow your heart. Well, this is going to be a short Devo because I don't have many feelings about this. I have strong feelings about this. And the Bible is very clear when it says that a fool hath no delight in understanding. What that's saying is, when you do not desire to understand wisdom, the knowledge that God gives through his word and the wisdom that God gives, and understanding comes when we apply the knowledge given to our lives. That makes it wisdom. Then when we see the application and the results of it, that gives understanding. A fool does not like these things. A fool doesn't want God's knowledge. It doesn't want to apply God's knowledge. It's actually quite foolish to have God's knowledge and not apply it to your life. And of course, when you don't apply the knowledge, you'll never have understanding. Why does a fool do this? Because his heart wants to discover itself. What is it saying? If you just want to follow your heart, the Bible says you're a fool. Not Pastor Larry. I do agree with what the Bible says. Every time I follow my heart, every time I do, and what all that is saying is when you say follow your heart is do what you want to do. Do what makes you happy. How about we try and do what pleases God in our lives? Have a good day. God bless. We'll see you Saturday at the Gore funeral. If you can be there, please pray for the Gore family. Pray for the Boers. I know they'll be traveling back tomorrow. Hope they're having a great time. Miss you guys. Have a good day. God bless.